We're going to cover five steps to getting your custom domain configured on Google Domains. Adding the domain to the project's settings, enabling SSL, DNS configuration, setting the default domain, and verifying. Let's add the custom domain. From project settings in the hosting tab, we're just typing out the domain name. And we want to make sure we have both the root version and the www version. And that's it. That's adding the custom domain. We're moving quickly. Let's enable SSL. All we'll do here is switch this to on. And we've now enabled SSL. Now let's configure DNS. We'll be adding or replacing three different records, two A records and a CNAME record. If your DNS settings already have one or more A records that have a name value of @, and if you already have a CNAME record that has a name value of www, you can remove or replace these. It's always a good idea to take screenshots or otherwise back up these records. Now, to access our DNS settings, if you're using Google Domains, we'll simply go into our DNS configuration, and we're going to get ready to simply copy and paste. And we can copy these to the clipboard one at a time. Over in the project settings, copy the first one to our clipboard. In our DNS configuration, we can simply paste in and press add. That's the first one. The second one will go faster because muscle memory. In our project settings, copy the second address. In our DNS settings, and this is a unique way it's done in Google Domains, we'll want to edit the first record we created, then press the tiny plus button. And we can paste in our second address, and of course, press save. Finally, we're going to add one last record for www. This is going to be a CNAME record, and all we have to do is go over to project settings, copy the address for our CNAME record, and take it back over to paste it in. Once we paste it in, we click add. That's it. That's DNS configuration. Let's set the www domain to default. We're just pressing the little button here, and now it's default. Finally, let's verify, and we'll simply press check status, making sure we're getting the correct information. Keep in mind that DNS changes can take a few hours, so you can always come back later if this isn't working right away. But once we're verified, we're all done. At any time, from our project settings, we can publish. Or from any page in the designer, we can publish. And publish again. Remember the complexity around FTP? Neither do we. Just publish. And that's setting up your custom domain.